Good morning, guys. Welcome back to another vlog. It is Tuesday, 7:55 in the morning, April 9th, and I'm heading to work. I know I have a giant fucking pimple on my chin. Ignore it. It is so unsightly and ugly. I don't know why I said unsightly. I've literally never said that before, and it hurts. It's really bothering me, so just pretend it's not there. Yesterday, we got back from Florida, so now we're like starting the beginning of our week on a Tuesday because we were in Florida over the weekend. We came home yesterday, so if you missed that vlog, go watch it because that was last week's vlog. But now we're like starting back into our regular week, a day late. So it's a day, one day short week, which is good. I'm heading to work. I'm really not, you know, very thrilled about it, but it's fine. It's just like, I just know today is gonna be annoying, but you know, it is what it is. I think I'll survive. It is supposed to be really nice this week. It's supposed to be like 78 today is the high, so I'm really happy about that. I think that we're finally into like consistent warm weather and we're not gonna get like below 60 again. Hopefully not even below like 70 again would be great until fall. So think that's where we're at, which, you know, is great because I'm so over the cold. When we were in Florida all weekend, I was just like, I cannot return home to Virginia and be freezing cold. I just cannot do it because I need the summer. I need the heat. I need the warm weather, like for real. But Leanna, our sister, is moving into her house this weekend, which is so crazy. If you missed a few vlogs ago, several vlogs ago, our sister Leanna bought a house. Her and her boyfriend bought a house, and so that is super exciting. So they closed on their house at the end of February, but the people who owned it rented back from them for like a month and a half because they are building a house and their house that they were building was not ready yet. So they are finally moving out this weekend so Leanna and Nelson can move in. And I'm really excited for them, and I haven't even gotten to see their house, which is so crazy because like she bought a whole ass house and I haven't even seen it. It's just crazy. This weekend, we're gonna obviously help them move. I don't know, like I don't feel like sad about it at all. My parents are like so sad. My mom's had like 14 Menti Bees about it. Like she'll just start like sobbing and she's like so sad about it. Like my dad's sad, but like I don't think it's sad. I think especially because Leanna, since dating Nelson, has spent a lot of nights over with him, like at his house or his apartment or whatever, so it's like not at all uncommon for her to not be home for like several days in a row. And then she's also like a nurse, so she like works night shifts and stuff, so like it's not like she's around all the time. So I think that's why I like just don't understand why my parents are like so sad about it, because I'm like, it's not really gonna be any different. Like they're only moving, like their house is like 15-20 minutes from our house, so it's not like they're like moving far or anything. So I'm like, it's really just not that serious. Like I don't feel sad about it at all. I just feel excited for them and a little envious, but you know, my time will come. Got to keep reminding myself that. Other life updates: Tito graduates in exactly 1 month with his master's degree, and I am so fucking excited for him to just be done with school. Very excited about that. So we are just waiting. He's applied to a bunch of jobs, and we're just waiting on the edge of our seat for hopefully someone to get back to him about a job. He wants to be a music teacher, like in a public school. So hopefully, the goal is that he'll get a job and start teaching this fall. So we will see. Everyone put out your good vibes, prayers, all the things that he does get a job offer, because that's really the next step that needs to happen so that the rest of our lives can happen. So we're kind of just in a holding pattern until he knows what he's doing for sure after he graduates. But this double chin of mine is not cute. I'll update you guys maybe later. I don't know. I finished a book while we were in Florida, so I need to do a book review of that, so I'll probably do that when I get home. And maybe let you know how my day goes, if I remember. So, yeah, gonna finish driving to work. Talk to you guys later.
Hey guys, today's Tuesday. It's my first day back to work from vacation. My face looks a little bit fake. It looks a little bit like claymation because of the fact that I got all that sun, but I look like I'm dying. And I can't wait to straighten my hair today because I feel ugly. Really boring in there. I've been running Urban on drive-thru, which just feels like a hate crime, honestly, but whatever, someone's gotta do it, I guess. But yeah, so can't wait to be done with this shift. It's like 8:30 or something, and I still have 3 hours. Freaking sucks. I think we're all going out tonight. We briefly mentioned it. So it'll be fun to see everybody. So that's the gist of today. It's actually really nice. That's so nice because we just got back from Florida, as you know if you keep up with the vlogs. Where of course it's like really warm and nice. But when we left, it was like cold. So it's so nice because we came back and it's going to be nice for the rest of the week in the near future. So I think it's officially spring, which is really exciting. But yeah, I just can't wait till I just am not here and I don't look like this anymore. So I guess I'll probably update you when that's the case. I just straightened my hair. So I'm feeling a little bit better about myself, but it's a little bit fluffy, but it feels so soft and so healthy. I also look like I got sun, because I did, but I felt dirty earlier. But now my forehead is peeling, which is really awkward. But I'm going to $2 Tuesday tonight with me friends, and I picked out an outfit and I felt kind of insecure about it because, you know, it's like literally new. But Ashley and Maggie both said they loved it, so I'll show you guys once I put it on. But I think I'm gonna do my makeup and my hair and then get dressed so I can get like the full effect and know if it actually looks stupid or not. Like, it's hard to tell when I don't have makeup on and my hair is a mess. Ow. I just bumped my hand. I'm gonna go finish getting ready. I'll come back once I'm done. All right, so I am ready. So I'll give you my OOT. Why am I always, I swear every time I saw a vlog clip, I'm like, all right, so, like, literally calm down. But this is what I'm wearing. This is the fit. Little romper slash overall thing Liana gave me. Polka dot tights, bandeau top, and my Converse. So that's a fit. So when we were in Florida, me and Maddie were like finding a bunch of seashells, obviously. And when I was little, we would like look for seashells with holes in them to make necklaces out of. So I like jokingly told my friends I was gonna make us all seashell necklaces. But then I was like, wait, Loki, I probably should. So I did, in fact, make us seashell necklaces. I already gave Allison hers, but it's also kind of awkward because I ran out of purple elastic. So one of them has to be pink, which is kind of like so awkward that one person's going to say no. So I'm going to see if Maggie wants it because it's her favorite color. If not, I'll take it so that like nobody feels like awkwardly left out. Cakes and gigs. Took me 3 seconds to make them, but Allison wore hers at work today, or at least while I was there. And I told her to wear it so that we all can match. And she said, I'll bring it. Like, I know it's not cute. Like, it's not like an everyday wear. But I literally made that for you. So, whatever. But I'm trying to debate if I should do my homework or not. Because I look kind of just, like, don't feel like it. So I might just, like, not do it. I probably should. But if I do it now, then I leave, then I'll probably be a little late. But if I leave right now, then I'll probably get there when everyone else does, because I need to get food too. So I'm probably just not going to do it, because I can make up for it. Like, I can do extra credit on the same assignments and get over 100 points. So I'm probably just not going to do it. Probably just do it all tomorrow, not going to lie. So yeah, about to leave then. I will update you guys when I'm with the gang. I'm going to go meet up with Maggie first. And then after that, we're going, so. So I did, in fact, not do my homework. I always look so ugly in this lighting because the way the shadowing is. But we got our seashell necklaces on. And Maggie did want the pink one, so it worked out. But she wanted it. And nobody had to feel like they had to fight over who got pink. So now we're going to go to Chick-fil-A because I feel like I'm going to throw up and die and pass out because I'm so hungry. And then I think we're going to $2 Deuced. Bro, my fucking eye has had, like, this weird, like, dryness. And I was thinking maybe it's because, like, when I'm at work and if I have, like, sanitizer on my hands, I always am like this. But it's just been dry for, like, weeks and it's so itchy. But it's time to go to get food so I don't pay a sale. Nah.
Okay, tell them what you said when you walked out.
I said I feel like a Christian girl on a youth retreat to Guatemala.
I know, just something about the way you speak that makes me feel so
cool.
They know that.
Cameron.
That was on the vlog.
It was on the vlog, and it got on my leg.
I was playing his favorite song. He got really excited.
I got really excited.
At least I got it on camera. I get all the mishaps on camera. Maybe I should just stop vlogging this past one.
Vlog your necklace. Is this dirty?
Vlog your Netflix.
Your Netflix?
Your Netflix.
Oh, okay.
I hope that they put that in the vlog.
You got our necklace? Our necklaces. Sorry,
Netflix.
Netflix!
Oh, we weren't saying anything.
Look who showed.
It's
giving biker chick.
My coffee's black in my bed at 3. You're too sweet for me.
I hate that. I hate this.
This
is Pink Bunny Club. Or Sisters, right? I don't know that song. What song is it?
Pink Bunny Club.
Okay. I don't know.
You're so precious.
Like, Jordan just has like
classy,
this obvious, like dumb crush on Tony.
Oh, we went in.
Maybe it was
don't
a
joke.
Jealousy thing. But I thought it was a jealousy thing about Jordan.
So good.
T-T-O-G-O. You can take me high to go. You can poison, baby girl. La 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 la. La 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 la. You can poison.
poison, poison, you're the worst. Venus, it will make your business out of it. Where we can find out.
The best day ever.
I'm so nervous.
What I get for free is not my fault.
Yeah, it's a ball clip.
Oh, for the vlog. The song you sent there. It was tummy hurts.
Yeah, and my tummy always does hurt.
That's so true.
I'm chronically ill.
Tummy hurt, girl.
That's me. You got it.
We're the only
ones in the bar. And we're having the best time.
I love it if we made it.
That's where we are.
Hey guys, it's Wednesday, and oh boy, 7 a.m. I'm on my way to work. So, literally, last time I went to $2 Tuesday, it was so much fun. Like, honestly, everyone was just having a really good time. We all ended up staying later than we expected to, just because we were all having like so much fun, and we got to play our music the whole night. Because sometimes they have been having a live band come on Tuesdays. But they were playing outside last night, so we get to play our music inside, like, on the jukebox. So we were having, like, way too much fun. But then I ended up having to sleep over at Allison's house. Oh my god, I'm scared. So, like, 1 in the morning, because Allison, for some reason, she opened this morning at 4:30. But for some reason, she was still awake around 1. So she said I could sleep over at her house, so I did in fact do that. The awkward thing is though that she didn't like wake up at 4:30 and go to work. So I was like, really, why are you even awake? But then I was like spiraling because I was like so stressed out. But it worked out. Definitely did not go to bed. Like, went fell asleep for like maybe like an hour. Woke up 4 in the morning. Leave Allison's because she was going to work. So I was like, but what's silly is last night, so I was debating for like a week if I should take this shift today that's from 6 a.m. to 11. But then I was like, no, I'm not going to take it. And then my coworker last night, that his shift was, texted me and she's like, hey, actually, my tire's like literally flat and I cannot get to work tomorrow. Like, send me a video and everything. Like, she literally cannot get to work. So she's like, so could you please take it? Like, I'm so sorry to like ask you again. And I was like, oh, like, I might. Like, depends on how late I get back and, like, whatever. But, like, Ash and Allison are both there. Like, whatever. I was like, maybe. I was like, I might show up, I might not. And I was making jokes about, like, coming in and saving the day or, like, whatever. But I was like, I'm pretty sure I was going to do it in the case, like, unless for some weird reason, like, I couldn't. So I was like, okay, guys. Like, it's literally, I'm waking up at 4 in the morning. I got, like, an hour of sleep at most. If I even got a full hour of sleep. I actually don't think I can do it. I'm so sorry. But I was like, if I can I just come in at like 7, if I like, you know, whatever. So went home, slept for like 2 hours because Allison said just try to come at 7, like don't worry about getting there at 6. Cause like I didn't even like take the shift. I just was like, well, I'll just like if you need me, like I'll just come in and help out. But like I didn't really like officially accept the shift, so it's not really my shift. Just kind of like. Responsibility that much. I'm just kind of being like helpful. So yeah, I went to bed for 2 hours. Woke up literally right after I woke up. Allison called me, but I went downstairs a lot of paper inside, so it was blasting through my house. And I was like, "Hi." She's like, "Are you coming?" And I was like, yeah, "I guess so." So now I'm going to work. She said I can leave around 10, hopefully. She's like, "You can probably leave by like 10." And I was like, "That would actually be so lovely." I mean, the shift is still 11, but if I could get back earlier, take a longer nap before dance, that would be so lovely. So we'll see how that goes. But I mean, all of us are running off of like no sleep. I'm lucky that I got more sleep than they did, honestly. But barely, because I had to drive all the way home. and then I couldn't even fall asleep. So it's really scary today, but at least my besties. Honestly, if it wasn't Allison and if it was literally anybody else who was the shift this morning, I would not be doing this, but she's lucky because I'm doing this for you, Allison. So you're welcome. I was just starving. I'm gonna die. This is how it's going today. Get up. Good morning, guys. Happy Wednesday. It is a new day and I am feeling great today. Okay, let me. It is Wednesday. It's 10:50 in the morning. I just finished having breakfast and stuff. I slept in today because, well, I slept in until like 9. But then I just laid in bed for a while because I was so fucking tired. Yesterday, I did not get off of work until literally 7 o'clock. We close at 5. Oh my god. We close at 5. We were there until 7. That's like the latest I've literally ever been stuck at work. Like, getting stuck at work until 6, even pushing 6:30, is not that uncommon. But 7 o'clock. Phoebe. We don't need your commentary. 7 o'clock is crazy. It was ridiculous. Literally at like 5:30. We had 3 emergency appointments in the clinic and 1 on the way. I was like, what the fuck is going on? It was ridiculous. So anyway, I was just like, I didn't like sleep great in Florida. I never sleep great when I like go on trips. Like, you know, you sleep the best in your own bed. So I didn't sleep great in Florida. And then we got home at like 8-ish, 9 o'clock. I think it was like 9 o'clock when we got home on Monday. And then like ate dinner, showered and stuff, went pretty much straight to bed, had to get up yesterday morning early to go to work. So I was just like so tired and then got stuck at work. I literally also had to go into work early yesterday because we had an 8:30 emergency too. Like, we had an appointment coming in early. So I literally got stuck at work for 11 fucking hours yesterday. I was so over it by the time I got home. But today it's supposed to be beautiful out. It's supposed to be like 77 and I'm so excited. So I'm gonna take my dogs to the park first thing this morning. I have so much I need/want to do today. I really want to clean out my car. I got like rubber car mats, like weatherproof car mats for my birthday from Caitlin and TJ. And I want to put those in my car, so I want to just like clean my car because it's I have 2 huskies. It's pretty hairy and gross in there. I also want to take my dogs to the park because it's so nice out. So that's like first thing I'm going to do today. Normally I just do that like on Wednesdays later in the day, like after I do all the shit I need to do, then I take them to the park. But I'm going to do that first. Just because that just felt like the right thing to do today. I also need to edit the vlog. So that's like always just like the worst part of my Wednesdays is that I have to edit the vlog and I have to find time to do that. But that's going to get put on the back burner for a little bit. I will get it done before the end of the day, but I'm just not going to, like, normally I try to get that done first, but it's just not my top priorities today because I just have other things I need and want to do more. So yeah. And then I need to do laundry. I still haven't like unpacked like my suitcases over there. I need to like do all that, clean up my room. Yeah, so that kind of stuff. And then I really want to start reading. I want to read today because I finished a book while we were in Florida, which I also need to do a book review on. The next book I'm starting is Mad Honey by Jodi Picou. And I've heard such good things about this book. So, like, I want to have, like, a sit outside and read moment today. So, just, like, all sorts of stuff on the agenda. But let me do a book review real quick. And then I need to take my dogs because this one's freaking out. I started this book on last Wednesday night and finished it on Monday, so literally that's like the fastest I've read a book in a long time. Helped that we were traveling on a plane a lot and then also sitting on a beach a lot, which is prime reading time. So I pretty much flew through this book. It is The Identicals by Ellen Hildebrand, and this was my second Ellen Hildebrand book, and I love her books. I love her writing style. She doesn't do like chapters, she just like flips between multiple characters' point of views. And so like instead of it being like chapter one, and like other authors who do that will be like chapter one Ainsley is, and then it'll be like chapter two Tabitha, but she doesn't like number her chapters. Like, it literally just like it'll mid-page start another character, and I don't know what it is about that, but I just like it makes me like read faster. I feel like it just makes it like
move along quicker almost, I feel like, which I really like. I hate a slow burn. I hate a book that has like, that just like, it takes so long to get to the point. I hate it. Like, just get to the point, which I feel like she does really well in her books. Like, they start off interesting and they never get boring. There's never a dull moment. But this book, The Identicals, is about two twin sisters. One of them lives on Nantucket and the other one lives on Martha's Vineyard. And they were separated when they were teenagers, when their parents got a divorce, one went with the mom, the other one went with the dad. And they end up switching places and like having like a whole, each have like their whole own romance situation going on. They switch places, like they hate each other, and then they like switch places and like come back together in the end. That was a horrible explanation of this book, but I feel like I can't explain that much more, or else I would give like the whole plot away. But it was so good. It was such like a, it wasn't necessarily a beachy read, but it was like a good like vibe because it takes place on Nantucket and Martha's Vineyard, and it just was like not a super dark read. There was like a little bit of mystery to it because you're like trying to figure out why they hate each other, like just, and then like some romance to it also. Like, it was just such a good story, a good book. It went, moved fast, it didn't drag on at all. Like, I am obsessed with Ellen Hildebrand's style of writing, and so this is only my second book by her, but I definitely need to read some more by her because I really, really enjoyed both books that I have read from her so far. Definitely gonna give this one a 5 out of 5 stars. It was so, so good. So yeah, that was, I think this is like my 7th or 8th book of the year. Really solid book. I enjoyed it a lot. For now, I need to go take my dogs to the park before they lose their minds, because I have made them wait way too long to go on a walk this morning. Neither of them have even peed this morning, and it's literally 11 a.m. So I've let them outside. They didn't want to go pee. It's not my fault. But anyway, gonna go take them to the park. I will bring you guys along with me. Let's go.
Fit check to take my dogs to the park. I am wearing this tank top from Shein. Wear this tank top literally all the time. Got my belt bag because I don't have reliable pockets for my phone. So put this on so I can put my phone in it. These shorts my aunt got me for Christmas, and they're super cute and comfy. It's actually my first time wearing them, so love that. And then my Vessi sneakers, which are so dirty because this path that we walk on is so muddy. So I literally can only wear these shoes because they're already ruined. And they're also waterproof, which is great in the mud. So anyway, it's 70 degrees right now. It's supposed to get up to 77, but it's really sunny. So I'm hoping that I'm not going to be cold in a tank top and shorts. I think I'll be fine. I don't know. We're just going to go with it.
It is literally so gorgeous out here. I cannot get over it. The sky is blue. Sun is out. Feels so nice. Truly thriving.
Just finished a 45-ish minute, almost 2-mile walk. It was super nice.
Bugs are exhausted. Luna's behind me over here. It got pretty hot. Like, at first I was a little chilly because I was just wearing a tank top, and I was like, I should have worn like my jacket. Like, I brought a jacket. I was like, I should have brought it because I was like getting a little chilly. But by the end of that, I was getting so, so hot, but like in a good way. Like, oh my god, I just love it. I'm so ready for summer. It is noon now, so I think I'm gonna go get a little Starbucks, and then go home and get the vlog going. So that's the plan.
Hey guys, I'm currently on my way to dance. Work today was definitely interesting. I ended up going in late. I think I said that. I got off early. We were so tired. I was gonna die the whole time. I was like vibrating. I was exhausted. My head was pounding. It was rough, but I made it through. And then I got home and I literally took a 3-hour nap, and I just like slept the whole time. Did not wake up once. Did not toss and turn. I literally closed my eyes, and all of a sudden I woke up. It was 3 hours later. I said, oh, honestly, for the best. But now I'm going to dance. I'd be there till 8 tonight. So I'm working on the comp dance tonight. Only other practice that I have for it with them. So hopefully it goes well and everything gets sorted out and it looks good by the end of tonight, because comp is in 2 weekends, I think. I don't think I'll be seeing them until that. So I'm really stressed out, but we're going to see Girl and Ride in concert next weekend. The next weekend is dance competition. The next weekend is Mother's Day, and then I'm going to Disney World. Isn't that freaking crazy? I'm so busy. But it's all worth it. It's all fun. It's all good. But yeah, that's my little update for right now. I have nothing really crazy going on, but it has been a really wacky, weird day. I have to work for 7 hours tomorrow. I'm so upset about that. And it's honestly kind of my fault for agreeing to stay for 2 extra hours. But you know what? I need the hours. It's going to be fine. I'll make it through. I'll survive. I've done it before. So, yeah, that's what's happening.
All right, guys, it's 3:45 now. I'm outside. I got my dogs out. And I'm about to clean out my car. I just took all my floor mats out, my old ones, because I got the rubber ones for my birthday. So I'm going to put those in. But I want to do a little before and after because I can't vlog. I'm making a TikTok, so I can't actually vlog cleaning my car since I'll be filming for TikTok instead. But I'm going to do a before and after of my car, and we'll see how long. Last time I deep cleaned my car, it took me 4 hours. So I'm not trying to stay out here for 4 hours because it's already 4 o'clock. But we will see how much I get done and how long it takes me. So let me show you how bad my car is before. These are my floor mats. I took them out because I have new ones, but you can see how freaking hairy they are thanks to these two. And then this is, oh my God, it's so bad. The amount of hair everywhere. I'm gonna go up front. So it's pretty disgusting in here. So we're gonna vacuum. I have a steam cleaner thing I'm gonna use and put in my new floor mats and wipe everything down, and we'll see how it goes. Good morning, guys. It is Thursday, 7:50 in the morning. I just got in my car and it kind of smells weird, and I don't know why it smells weird considering I spent hours yesterday cleaning it. It doesn't smell bad, it just smells kind of odd. I don't know what that's about. I had to go get gas right now and then go pick up Starbucks for me and my coworker. It's her last day today, so I do in fact want to just crawl under a rock and die there, because I just know that I'm going to forever hate my job now. That might be a little dramatic. Trying to just convince myself that everything will just be fine, because a couple years ago when the coworker I started my job with quit, I was really upset about that as well, and then it ended up being even better after she left, to be honest. So I'm just trying to tell myself that it'll be fine and everything will work out and it'll end up being okay. But as of right now, I just kind of feel homicidal, so you know, there's that. But what can you do? Unfortunately, I cannot control other people's life choices, so nothing I can do about it. Just gotta suck it up. But I do have to get gas because I have 66 gallon or miles left in my tank, so gonna get gas. And let's get some gas together. I am at work right now by myself because my doctor's out today, so I'm just here holding down the fort. And I have had the craziest day, seriously. I got to work this morning and my doctor lives here at the, this is her house, but the basement for the clinic, and then she lives upstairs. And the whole property is fenced in, and there's a gate that has a code to let you in, so no one can just get in. So anyway, I get here and I pull into the parking lot and I go to get out of my car, and there's just a guy in the front yard. And I was looking at him and I was who is that guy? But I was she must just my doctor must just know him because she lives here. So I was maybe he's just a friend or family member or something that I've never met before. I don't know. So I just didn't really think anything of it. And then I came into the clinic and the phone was ringing, and it was my doctor calling the office phone from her cell phone. So I answered it and she was Kylie, there's a man in the yard. And I was yeah, I see that. And she's I don't know who that is. We need to call 911. She's I'm calling her husband. She's I'm calling my husband. He's going to come over here and figure it out. But we need to call 911. Can you call 911? So I had to call 911. I've never called 911 in my life. I was freaking out. did not want to be calling 911, but I call 911 and I like tell them what's going on, and like it actually wasn't that scary to call 911, so you know, I kind of feel better knowing that I've done that now, so I don't need to freak out about having to do it in the future. But still, it was like really like I was freaking out. I'm like frantically locking all the doors. Like I had unlocked the door when I came in, as I always do. I'm like running over, I like relock it, I go check the back door, lock the back door. 911's like, yeah, we'll send someone. I'm like, okay. So then my doctor calls again and she's like, call the neighbor, because there's the guy, there's like a man who lives next door who's like a client of ours, but also like her next door neighbor, so we know him. And so I call him and I like tell him what's going on. So he comes over here so fast. He sees the guy, he scares the guy off. Like he was like, you need to get out of here. So he got rid of the guy before the cops could even come. And then he was pretty sure the guy was on drugs. So, which makes a lot of sense, because the guy was like not wearing any shoes and he was just like in the yard, but then he would like keep just like collapsing down to the ground, like as if he was like hiding or something. Like he would just fall down to the ground, like on his stomach. It was really weird. So he thinks the guy was on drugs, but yeah. So then he like scared the guy off. The guy like took off. And then the cops came, and then my doctor's husband came over because they like just got married, so they have two separate like houses, like whatever. So he came over because he wasn't here. So he came over and like walked the entire property with his gun, and then like came and like zip tied like all the gates closed and everything. But like the guy had to have scaled the fence to get in, because the gate was closed and you have to have a code to get in. And like it was like I put in the code and got in when I got here, so the gate was closed, and he was here already when I pulled in, so he must have like scaled the fence. it was crazy. So yeah, so then I like, now I'm here by myself today, so I was like freaking out. I'm like texting my family, I'm like, I'm literally at work by myself and there's like this crazy man on the loose, because the cops didn't find him because he was gone by the time they got here. And they did like drive around and look for him, but they didn't find him. So anyway, now like I have the door locked and I just put a sign on it. I'm like, if you're a client, like please knock and I'll come let you in. But I'm not like unlocking the door, and I have a camera pulled up that's showing me like the whole like driveway and stuff, so I can at least see that in case someone like returns to the driveway, I'll know. And then the neighbor knows that I'm here by myself, so he was like, I'll be home, like if you need me to come over just call me and I'll come over. So it's like fine, like I'm not scared or anything, but it was really stressful. It was like just really weird. It was a really crazy way to start the day, seriously. I've never called 911 before, like the whole thing was so stressful. But anyway, yeah, it's Friday, I'm here by myself today, so it's an easy day. I'm just dealing with like phone ringing, picking medication pickups, things like that. It's currently 12:40, so have a few more hours left of the day and then going home. But yeah, I just wanted to tell you guys that story because it was really crazy. Like I literally, when I got here and I saw him, I was just like I did think, like I was like, who is that man? Because he was being like, he looked just like weird, but I was like, I don't know, like it must just be family member. So I just like came in, like didn't think anything of it, unlocked the door, like whatever. No, just some guy on drugs, like trespassing and doing Lord knows what because he was on drugs. So anyway, no, very exciting eventful start to my day. But just want to tell you guys that story because it was crazy.
Good morning, guys. It's Saturday. I look bald today, but I promise my hair is just all back here in a clip. I'm not bald. It's Saturday. It is April 13th, and it is 9:04 in the morning. I am up and ready today. I am about to go take my dogs on a walk and Cooper, because Cooper's here, because Tito was here last night, but Tito had to go to work. So now just Cooper's here. So I have to take care of Cooper. But I'm about to go take the three of them on a walk, and then we have an exciting day. I feel like bittersweet day, except it's not really bitter for me, but like it's like in theory it should be. I mean, not really. Honestly, I don't know. For other people, it would probably be bittersweet. But today, the first Makel sibling is moving out. Leanna and her boyfriend bought a house, and they are moving in today, which is just so crazy. Like, I don't know. It's just so crazy to me that, like, one of us is actually moving out. Like, I don't even feel a little bit sad about her moving out, because honestly, it's just not that serious, and their house is, like, 15 minutes away, and also she's, like, spend so much time at Nelson, her boyfriend's apartment anyway, up until this point, that like she basically only lived here part-time anyway, so it's really just not that serious. But so I'm not like sad about it, but it's just like weird. I don't know if any of my other siblings feel this way. I know my mom and my dad, mostly my mom, are having like a whole conniption about this. I don't feel sad, I just, it feels just like weird. Like, it's just, like, crazy that we're not going to live together anymore. But also, I don't feel like it's going to really be any different. So that's why I'm, like, not sad. I just, like, the idea of it's just, like, crazy to me. I don't know. And the fact that she, like, bought a house, like, it's just so exciting. So excited and happy for them. So wish it was me. But trying to keep those feelings in. I'm, like, not, like, jealous. I'm just, like, I don't know. Like, I don't feel, like, jealous. I feel really happy for them. I just, like, wish it was me. Which, like, is jealousy. But, like, I don't feel jealous. Today, they are moving in officially. So we are, my whole family is available. And then Maddie's here. And Tito had to work this morning. But he'll be here later to help. So we are going over to their house. Me, Leanna, my mom, Caitlin, and Maddie are going to go over and start cleaning stuff while Nelson, Leanna's boyfriend, goes and gets the U-Haul. And then him and my dad and TJ, our brother, are going to load up all their stuff in the U-Haul and then drive it over to their house. And then we're going to, like, unpack and everything. Whole day of moving. Also, I'll bring you guys along. I'll do a little house tour if, I'm sure Leanna won't care. So I'll do a little house tour for you guys if you guys want to see it. But yeah, we are supposed to leave here around like 9:30, and it's 9:07. So I need to go because I need to walk my dogs before I go anywhere. Yeah, that's what's happening today. It's crazy. It is like, it feels like just not that long ago that we were moving into this house, and now first one moving out, and it's not the oldest one, which would be me. So, you know, I think that I have a lot of really complex feelings lately about life in general, but I think that my biggest issue right now is less jealousy, and because I truly, and I've been jealous a lot of times, Phoebe, and I truly do not feel jealous. I think that I feel a little bit like insecure because she's younger than me. And also just like being 26 and living at home is enough to make anyone feel insecure. And then when your younger sister's like buying a house, then you really feel insecure. So I think that's more my problem than like straight up jealousy. But you know, I probably should get a therapist. Also, I don't know how girls wear their hair like slick back like this and don't feel like a man. I feel like a man. Like, I just feel like I need to keep doing this so you guys know that I do in fact have hair. Anyway, as you can hear, my dogs are freaking the fuck out. I'm gonna take them out real quick, and then when we get to Leanna's house, I will show you guys. All right, we just made it to Leanna's house.
Just a silent house.
I was queuing up the camera. My mom just dropped me off here. Leanna drove here herself, and then she went back to Caitlin and Maddie. But I'm gonna show you guys her house. It's really cute. I look like such a man because of my hair, so just ignore that. But anyway, okay, let's go. All right, so you walk in the house. This is what you see, little foyer. They have a little like closet. Over here to the right is their like living room situation. And then you can go through here to their kitchen, which is a really nice kitchen. Island, all things, their pantry. Nice, although these are really fucking loud, so I don't really like those. Nice fridge area for like a table or whatever. And then their family room is right off their kitchen. And you also have their deck. They have a really nice deck. It just looks like this. It's really nice. And then if you go this way, over here is a powder room. This is their garage. And then down there is their basement. I'll take you down there in a second. We can go up the stairs. And if you go this way to the left, you have their laundry room. There's a nice big laundry room. And then this is one of the bedrooms that I think Nelson is gonna use. It's just like his whatever room, gaming, whatever, closet. Come out of this room and go down the hallway. They have this bedroom, which they're gonna use as their guest room. And they have a nice big closet in this room. And directly across, well, let's go next door, is the hall bath.
Ellie's bathroom. And then across from that bedroom is the master bedroom. So this is Leanna Nelson's bedroom. And then in here, they have their bathroom. Bathtub, shower, and then through there is their closet. Nice big closet. This whole house is disgusting. Like, look at the carpets. So we need to get it cleaned, but okay, anyway. Going back down their stairs. There's Leanna in her kitchen. And if you go this way, this is their basement, and it's an unfinished basement. So you go through this door, down some more stairs, and their basement is unfinished. They're gonna finish it eventually, but like not really anytime soon, but eventually they wanna finish it. And then down through here is their backyard, which is a pretty nice backyard. Lock that so no one kidnaps them. And then that's it. That's the whole house. Oh my gosh, you're out of breath from doing that little tour for you guys. So it's really nice. Really nice first home. How do you feel about it?
I'm feeling very pleased.
Yeah. So we're gonna get started cleaning because I mean look at their freezer. Oh, jump scare, disgusting. Went to put Nelson's bagel bites in there and immediately said, nope, not doing that. Okay. So we're gonna start cleaning and yeah.